Welcome to the North American Amateur League Team Fight Breakdown of the Week. My name is Kelvar, and today we're going to be breaking down the barren team fight between 3rd place TC Snitz and 1st place Digital Esports. This game had to be my favorite of the entire season thus far, featuring two of the top teams. It really showed the slugfest that these two teams kind of bring to each of their games. While it may look like TC Snitz have the advantage with the kills, TDE actually have the gold lead because they've just been out-farming and out-rotating TC Snitz. Now, Snitz knows they need to make a play because TDE are incredibly good at macro rotations and objective control, which is why they go for this Baron fight here. And going into this, they actually have the gold deficit, which makes this incredibly risky, but they go for it anyways because they know they have to make a play. It starts with TC Snitz just controlling the Baron with the wards, but then they see Morgana bot, and they realize this is their one chance to actually take the Baron. Now, Morgana does have a TP, which they take into consideration, but they start up the Baron regardless. Now, the teleport from Morgana comes out when the Baron's at about 50% health. Jinx throws her Chompas, Jarvan throws his Demacian Standard, that's the perfect response. However, Morgana has a clutch Black Shield that negates everything. Morgana couldn't have really played that any more perfectly, other than maybe hitting one or two more people with her ultimate. She only actually locked down the front line of TC Snitz in the Jarvan and the Poppy. Another massive factor is that Nami did not hit a single person with her ultimate. Meanwhile, Azir has this ultimate that looks like a total whiff and doesn't hit anyone. However, it does a fantastic job at pushing off all of TDE's damage dealers and forcing them to focus the tanks of TC Snitz. TDE end up blowing all of their massive teamfight cooldowns on the tanks of TC Snitz, which allows Azir and Jinx to plow damage into this backline of TDE and the Caitlyn and the Nami. The only one damage dealer left alive after this would be Graves, and he already used most of his cooldowns to kill Poppy. This teamfight could have gone so much better for TDE if they just turned around and dealt with the damage dealers of TC Snitz, but that Azir wall allowed the backline to just deal damage upon damage to the backline of TDE, which meant they had no threats left, and on top of that, they got a Baron, so they were able to push down objectives and eventually take the game and the first loss for TDE. For more content like this, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And to get in on the action, be sure to tune into our stream at twitch.tv/NAAmateurLeague every Tuesday and Friday night at 6 p.m. EST.